ਸੋ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਪਿਆਰੇ ਬੱਚਿਓ ਸਤਿ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਅਕਾਲ। ਸੋ ਅੱਜ ਦੀ ਇਸ ਵੀਡੀਓ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਸਾਇੰਸ ਕਲਾਸ 6 ਲੈਸਨ 1 ਫੰਡਾਮੈਂਟਲ ਆਫ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਪਾਠ ਦਾ ਅਭਿਆਸ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਹਾਜ਼ਰ ਹੋਏ ਹਾਂ। ਸੋ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਕਿ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਜਾਣਦੇ ਹੋ ਕਿ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਸਾਇੰਸ ਦੀ ਕਲਾਸ 6 ਦੀ ਕਿਤਾਬ ਦਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸਿਲੇਬਸ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਚੇਂਜ ਹੋ ਚੁੱਕਿਆ ਹੈ। ਸੋ ਇੰਗਲਿਸ਼ ਮੀਡੀਅਮ ਦੇ ਸਿਲੇਬਸ ਨੂੰ ਧਿਆਨ 'ਚ ਰੱਖਦੇ ਹੋਏ ਅਸੀਂ ਇਸ ਵੀਡੀਓ ਦੇ ਰਾਹੀਂ ਲੈਸਨ 1 ਦੀ ਐਕਸਰਸਾਈਜ਼ ਦੀ ਵੀਡੀਓ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਹਾਜ਼ਰ ਹੋਏ ਹਾਂ, ਜਿਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਇਹ ਸਾਡੇ ਕੋਲ ਮਲਟੀਪਲ ਚੋਇਸ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ, ਜਿਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਫਸਟ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਹੈ ਜੀ, ਵਿਚ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਫਾਲੋਇੰਗ ਇਜ਼ ਨੋਟ ਏ ਪਾਰਟ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਆਈਪੀਓ ਸਾਈਕਲ ਐਂਡ ਦੇਰ ਆਪਸ਼ਨਸ ਆਰ ਪ੍ਰੋਸੈਸਿੰਗ, ਇਨਪੁਟ ਯੂਨਿਟ, ਆਊਟਪੁਟ ਯੂਨਿਟ ਐਂਡ ਲਾਸਟ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਸਪੀਡ ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਰਾਈਟ ਆਨਸਰ ਇਜ਼ ਸਪੀਡ ਇਜ਼ ਨੋਟ ਏ ਪਾਰਟ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਆਈਪੀਓ ਸਾਈਕਲ। ਐਂਡ ਸੈਕਿੰਡ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਇਜ਼ ਵਿਚ ਇਜ਼ ਨੋਟ ਏ ਕਰੈਕਟਰਿਸਟਿਕ ਆਫ ਏ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਐਂਡ ਦੇਰ ਆਪਸ਼ਨਸ ਆਰ ਐਕੂਰੇਸੀ, ਨੋ ਆਈਕਿਊ, ਡਿਲੀਜੈਂਸ ਐਂਡ ਲਾਸਟ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਸਟੋਰੇਜ। ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਰਾਈਟ ਆਨਸਰ ਇਜ਼ ਡਿਲੀਜੈਂਸ ਇਜ਼ ਨੋਟ ਏ ਕਰੈਕਟਰਿਸਟਿਕ ਆਫ ਏ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ। ਐਂਡ ਥਰਡ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਵਿਚ ਪਾਰਟ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਇਜ਼ ਰਿਸਪੋਂਸੀਬਲ ਫੋਰ ਪਰਫੋਰਮਿੰਗ ਕੈਲਕੂਲੇਸ਼ਨ ਐਂਡ ਲੋਜੀਕਲ ਓਪਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ। ਐਂਡ ਦੇਰ ਆਪਸ਼ਨਸ ਆਰ ਮੈਮਰੀ, ਏ ਐਲ ਯੂ, ਕੰਟਰੋਲ ਯੂਨਿਟ ਐਂਡ ਲਾਸਟ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਨਨ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਅਬਵ। ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਰਾਈਟ ਆਨਸਰ ਇਜ਼ ਏ ਐਲ ਯੂ ਪਾਰਟ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਇਜ਼ ਰਿਸਪੋਂਸੀਬਲ ਫੋਰ ਪਰਫੋਰਮਿੰਗ ਕੈਲਕੂਲੇਸ਼ਨ ਐਂਡ ਲੋਜੀਕਲ ਓਪਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ। ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਫੋਰਥ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਵਿਚ ਮੈਮਰੀ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਕੈਨ ਬੀ ਡਾਇਰੈਕਟਲੀ ਐਕਸੈਸ ਬਾਈ ਦੀ ਸੀਪੀਯੂ। ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਆਪਸ਼ਨਸ ਆਰ ਪ੍ਰਾਇਮਰੀ ਮੈਮਰੀ, ਆਗਜ਼ੀਲਰੀ ਮੈਮਰੀ, ਸੈਕੰਡਰੀ ਮੈਮਰੀ ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਲਾਸਟ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਸੀਡੀ ਔਰ ਡੀਵੀਡੀ। ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਰਾਈਟ ਆਨਸਰ ਇਜ਼ ਪ੍ਰਾਇਮਰੀ ਮੈਮਰੀ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਕੈਨ ਬੀ ਡਾਇਰੈਕਟਲੀ ਐਕਸੈਸ ਬਾਈ ਦੀ ਸੀਪੀਯੂ। ਦ ਫਿਫਥ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਵਿਚ ਪੋਰਟੇਬਲ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਿੰਗ ਡਿਵਾਈਸ ਇਜ਼ ਯੂਜਲੀ ਇਕਵਿਪਡ ਵਿਦ ਫੀਚਰਸ ਲਾਈਕ ਕੈਮਰਾ, ਲਾਰਜ ਸਟੋਰੇਜ ਕੈਪੈਸਿਟੀ ਐਂਡ ਹਾਈ ਪ੍ਰੋਸੈਸਿੰਗ ਸਪੀਡ। ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਆਪਸ਼ਨਸ ਆਰ ਸਮਾਰਟਫੋਨ, ਟੈਬਲੇਟ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ, ਲੈਪਟਾਪ ਐਂਡ ਲਾਸਟ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਆਲ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਅਬਵ। ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਰਾਈਟ ਆਨਸਰ ਇਜ਼ ਆਲ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਅਬਵ ਪੋਰਟੇਬਲ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਿੰਗ ਡਿਵਾਈਸ ਇਜ਼ ਯੂਜਲੀ ਇਕਵਿਪਡ ਵਿਦ ਫੀਚਰਸ ਲਾਈਕ ਕੈਮਰਾ, ਲਾਰਜ ਸਟੋਰੇਜ ਕੈਪੈਸਿਟੀ ਐਂਡ ਹਾਈ ਪ੍ਰੋਸੈਸਿੰਗ ਸਪੀਡ। ਸੋ ਹੁਣ ਅਸੀਂ ਪਾਠ ਦੇ ਟਰੂ ਫੋਲਸ ਬਾਰੇ ਪੜਾਂਗੇ। ਫਸਟ ਵਨ ਹੈ ਜੀ, ਇਹ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਕੈਨ ਨੋਟ ਮੇਕ ਐਨੀ ਡਿਸੀਜ਼ਨ ਔਨ ਇਟਸ ਓਨ, ਟਰੂ। ਸੈਕਿੰਡ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਪਰਸਨਲ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਆਰ ਆਲਸੋ ਕਾਲਡ ਮਾਈਕਰੋ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ, ਟਰੂ। ਥਰਡ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਆਊਟਪੁਟ ਡਿਵਾਈਸਿਸ ਆਰ ਯੂਜ਼ ਟੂ ਡਿਸਪਲੇ ਇਨਫੋਰਮੇਸ਼ਨ ਜਨਰੇਟਡ ਬਾਈ ਏ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਔਰ ਅਦਰ ਇਲੈਕਟ੍ਰੋਨਿਕ ਡਿਵਾਈਸਿਸ, ਟਰੂ। ਫੋਰਥ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਪ੍ਰਾਇਮਰੀ ਮੈਮਰੀ ਇਜ਼ ਆਲਸੋ ਕਾਲਡ ਆਗਜ਼ੀਲਰੀ ਮੈਮਰੀ ਔਰ ਐਕਸਟਰਨਲ ਮੈਮਰੀ, ਫਾਲਸ। ਫਿਫਥ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ YouTube, 3D and virtual reality devices are popular in the entertainment industry, true. So, we will start the full forms. This is first one is RAM, and RAM stands for random access memory. Second one is ROM. ROM stands for read-only memory. Third one is CPU. CPU stands for central processing unit. Fourth one is HDD. HDD stands for hard disk drive. Fifth one is ALU. ALU stands for arithmetic logic unit. Sixth one is GB. GB stands for gigabyte. Seventh one is MB. MB stands for megabyte. So, this is part of the short answer question. We will study this. This is the first question. Define computer. And the answer is, a computer is an electronic device that processes data into information according to specified instructions or programs. It performs mathematical and logical operations and provide a result. A computer works at high speed and is used in various fields such as education, business, medicine and science. And second one is, what is the role of ALU in a computer. And the answer is ALU stands for Arithmetic Logic Unit, which is used to perform mathematical and logical operations in a computer. It performs mathematical operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, etc. It handles logical operations like AND, OR, NOR, XOR, etc. ALU compares two numbers and gives the result. It is an important part of CPU, which play a major role in data processing. And third one is write any four characteristics of a computer. And the four characteristics of a computer are, the first one is high speed, second one is accuracy, third one is large storage capacity, and fourth one is ability to work continuously. And the fourth question is, what is the role of computer in the field of education? And the answer is, computer plays an important role in the education sector. It is used for online learning, smart classroom, and research. Student can access digital learning material with its help. It is also very helpful in online assignment, test, and administrative tasks. And the fifth question is, what are secondary memories? And their answer is, secondary memory is the memory that is used to store data for a long time. It is slower than primary memory, RAM, but has a larger storage capacity. And the examples are hard drive, which are HDD, SSD. Second one is USB drive, and that is pen drive, flash drive. Third one is memory card. Fourth one is CD or DVD. And last one is cloud storage. And sixth question is, what do you mean by portable devices? And the answer is, portable devices are electronic devices that are lightweight, easily portable, and can run on batteries. So, and their examples are smartphone, laptop, and tablet, USB drive and external hard disk, e-reader, smart watches, and fitness band. So, ਹੁਣ ਅਸੀਂ ਇਸ ਪਾਰਟ ਦੇ ਲੌਂਗ ਆਨਸਰ ਕੁਐਸਚਨਸ ਬਾਰੇ ਪੜਾਂਗੇ। ਇਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਪਹਿਲਾ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਹੈ ਜੀ, ਐਕਸਪਲੇਨ ਇਨ ਡਿਟੇਲ ਦੀ ਯੂਜ਼ ਆਫ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਇਨ ਡੇਲੀ ਟਾਸਕ। ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਆਨਸਰ ਇਜ਼, ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਹੈਜ਼ ਬਿਕਮ ਐਨ ਇੰਟੈਗਰਲ ਪਾਰਟ ਆਫ ਮਾਡਰਨ ਲਾਈਫ। ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਨਾਟ ਓਨਲੀ ਯੂਜ਼ ਫਾਰ ਆਫਿਸ ਵਰਕ, ਬਟ ਆਲਸੋ ਪਲੇਜ਼ ਐਨ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਟ ਰੋਲ ਇਨ ਡੇਲੀ ਪਰਸਨਲ ਐਂਡ ਬਿਜ਼ਨਸ ਵਰਕ। ਗਿਵਨ ਬਿਲੋ ਆਰ ਸਮ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਮੇਨ ਏਰੀਆਜ਼ ਵੇਅਰ ਦੀ ਯੂਜ਼ ਆਫ ਕੰਪਿਊਟਰ ਹੈਜ਼ ਬਿਕਮ ਵੈਰੀ ਕਾਮਨ। ਦੀ ਫਸਟ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ office work and management. So computer are used in offices for document preparation, data storage, and communication. Software like Microsoft Office, Word, Excel, PowerPoint are used to increase efficiency. Communication is done easily through email and video calls. Second one is education and research. Students and teachers adopt a new way of learning with the help of online learning, e-books, and online lectures. Student can submit assignment online through computers. Access to library and educational resources has become easier. And third one is entertainment. So people use computers to watch movies, songs, and play games. Entertainment has become easier through OTT platforms like Netflix, Amazon Prime. So people stay connected to the world through social media like Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. And fourth one is business and e-commerce. People shop online through Amazon, Flipkart. Computer are used to maintain account, transaction, and store business document in businesses. E-commerce website and apps provide great opportunity for businessmen. And fifth one is banking and financial transaction. Transaction have become easier through online banking, digital payment like UPI, PayPal, Google Pay, etc. People can buy bills, check balances, and get information about new schemes while sitting at home. And the sixth one is medical sector. Computer are used in hospital for maintaining patient record, online consultation, and digital reporting. Doctor also use computers for diagnosing diseases, scanning, and medication information. Seventh one is science and technology. So computers are important for new research and technological development. Computer are used by NASA and other scientific organizations for astronomy and aircraft development. So second question is, draw a block diagram of a computer system and explain all its parts. And the answer is, block diagram of a computer system and its parts are, a computer is an electronic machine that processes data and convert it into useful information. It is made up of several parts that work together. The first one is input unit. This part refers to the devices that enter data or instruction into the computer. And the examples are keyboard, mouse, scanner, microphone. Second one is the central processing unit. The CPU is the brain of the computer, which handles all the tasks. It is divided into three parts. The first one is arithmetic and logic unit. It performs mathematical operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and logical operation like AND or NOT. Second one is control unit. It gives instruction to all the part of the system. It determines which process should be executed at what time. And the third one is register. These are small and fast memories which are used to store data immediately. And the third one is memory unit. It is used to store data and instruction. And the first one is primary memory. Primary memory is a fast memory which is directly accessed by CPU. And the first type is RAM. So RAM stands for random access memory. So it is a temporary memory which stores data as long as the computer is running. And second one is ROM. ROM stands for read-only memory. It is a permanent memory in which the basic instructions or BIOS of the computers are stored. And second one is secondary memory. Secondary memory is not directly accessed by the CPU, but CPU store data after processing into the secondary memory. So hard disk, SSD, pen drive, CD, DVD, etc., which can store data for a long time. And fourth one is output unit. These devices are used to convey the information stored in the computer to the user. And its example are monitor, printer, speakers. And third question is, what are the difference between primary memory and secondary memory? And the difference are, look at the table. There are three columns. The first one is characteristics, primary memory, and the last one is secondary memory. And the first difference is speed. Primary memory is very fast in speed, whereas the secondary memory is very slow in speed. Second one is data storage. Primary memory stores data in a temporary manner, whereas secondary memory store data in a permanent manner. Third one is example. Primary memory examples are RAM and ROM, whereas ਸੈਕੰਡਰੀ ਮੈਮਰੀ ਐਗਜ਼ੈਂਪਲਸ ਆਰ HDD, SSD, USB, CD or DVD. And the fourth one is CPU access. Primary memory has direct access to the CPU, whereas the secondary memory can store data after the processing of the CPU. And the last one is cost. Primary memory is very expensive in cost, whereas secondary memory is very cheap in cost. The fourth question is, describe the different type of computers. And the answer is, different type of computer are, the first one is supercomputer. So a supercomputer is a computer that is very large in size and is considered the largest computer in the world. Second one is, these computers are very fast and complete the task in a very short time. Supercomputers are used to process large amount of data. This computer is considered the most powerful computer in the world because the performance of the processor of this computer is very good. So thousands of processors are interconnected in a supercomputer, due to which it can perform any task at a high speed. This computer is used to complete scientific and engineering related tasks such as weather forecasting and research, etc. So some of its famous examples are Parham 800, Parham 8000 and NUDT, Tihany 2, etc. Second one is mainframe computer. Mainframe computers are large in size and are used to store large amount of data. Mainframe computers have high functionality. Its size is larger than mini and microcomputer. It is a multi-user computer, so it can be used by more than one user at a time. This computer was invented by IBM in the 1950s. This computer is used in large companies and government offices to store large amount of data. However, these computers are also quite expensive. Example of these computers are IBM Z series, System Z9, etc. And third one is mini computer. Mini computer is a special type of computer whose size is neither too small or nor too big. This computer is larger than microcomputer but smaller than mainframe computer. It is a multi-user computer. This means that this computer can be used by one or more user at a time. Apart from this, it is also a multitasking computer. That is, more than one task can be done in this computer at a time. So fourth one is microcomputer. A microcomputer is a computer that can be used by only one person at a time. The size of this computer is quite small. It is much smaller than mini and mainframe computers. Apart from being lightweight, it is also very cheap. Microcomputer is multitasking, which means that the user can do many tasks on this computer at the same time, like surfing the internet, working in words and listening to song, etc. So some of the popular examples of these computers are laptop, smartphone, tablet, etc. So if you like this video, please subscribe and like this video. Thank you.